and welcome to Facts on Four. My name is Susan Nicastro. I'm the ward counselor representing Ward 4 here in the city of Brockton. My phone number is 508-941-0108. Since I became the counselor on January 1st of this year, I've been doing all sorts of things, and I want to use this show to spread the word about Ward 4 in Brockton. Current happenings, history, and what's keeping me busy as your Ward 4 counselor. So what do I do as a city councilor representing Ward 4? Well, the city council meets regularly. In most instances, they meet every week on a Monday night, unless the Monday is a legal holiday, and then they meet on the Tuesday, the next day. The city council is vested by the city of Brockton's charter with legislative powers. That means that we make ordinances and rules that must be followed in the city of Brockton. We can submit questions to voters. We can confirm appointments by the mayor. We approve the city budget as proposed by the mayor. We can approve, we can reduce, or we can reject the budget, but we can't add any funds to it. And in fact, last week, that's what we were doing. We met on three consecutive nights to review the budget as proposed by the city. And it probably took me about 15 hours to prepare for those three meetings. It was very intense doing my first budget. We can't vote on any question or serve on any committee where our private interests are immediately concerned, that distinct from that of the community. That's our conflict of law provision. We do much more than those things, though. Constituent services are a big part of what I do as a city councilor. Since January 2nd, I've had 86 constituent calls on all sorts of topics, a range of about 12 or 13 topics. But the top three topics that I've heard about are issues involving code enforcement, that's number one, streets and sidewalks is number two, and criminal activity is number three. Let's talk about code enforcement for a minute. The purpose of code enforcement is to protect the health and well-being of our residents in areas like sanitation, nuisance, junk cars, abandoned buildings, and license violations, mainly involving car repair shops, also victuallers and alcoholic beverages licenses. If you have issues in any of these areas, call me, 508-941-0108, and I will help you about with Ward 4 matters, okay? My big concerns right now as we head into the summer months are quality of life issues, safety, public safety, crime, issues that involve the pursuit of happiness, like noise issues, your being able to enjoy your backyard without being disturbed. I'm also concerned about economic development. So far, since being sworn in on January 1st, I've met with 9 owners of businesses in Ward 4 to introduce myself, to listen to what their businesses are all about, to talk about their concerns, and what we can do to help them. Because, you know, I want every business in Ward 4 to succeed. More businesses succeeding is good for all of our citizenry. Of course, you have to succeed within the parameters of what you're allowed to do by law and by license, as the case may be. I joined the Campello Business Association a year ago, and I attend their monthly meetings to listen to business owners, to find out what's going on in our Ward 4 neighborhood, and to be a good citizen and good business owner. I keep in touch with the City Office of Planning and Economic Development. I like to meet our city planner, Rob May, for coffee regularly. I learn so much from him. He's very experienced. I find that this is going to be the keys to helping Ward 4 be strong economically. And you should know that last year, I don't have a census for Ward 4. You know, the national census will be done in 2020. We're coming up to that. But I do know that last year, we had 7,688 registered voters in Ward 4, And I would love to see that number increase, especially as we approach the fall with the primary and the general election for state office holders. Now, what can you do to help Ward 4? Well, the most important thing you can do is to speak up if you see something. And an issue of emergency or crime type is something that you should report directly to the police. And you should keep calling the police if you don't see a police presence, you know, pretty soon. They always prioritize the calls that they get in according to necessity. So keep calling if you see something and you don't see them turn up yet. Other issues like a pothole, a street that needs paving, issues along those lines, you can go onto the city's website and use C-Click-Fix to report those issues. You can do it anonymously or you can use your name. It's up to you. Or you can call me about issues like that, 508-941-0108. You can also call me about issues involving crime or emergency, but you'll get a more direct response if you call the police and then call me so I can follow up for you. I would also ask you, as part of what's your role in helping Ward 4, be a good citizen. Get to know your neighbors. I really feel that if we all knew our neighbors as perhaps we once did a generation or two ago, we wouldn't have some of the issues arising in neighborhoods that we do now. Keep your homes neat on the outside especially. Don't litter as you walk or drive. Let's be proud of Ward 4. Let's keep it clean and neat. And also when you're driving, observe the speed limit, which is usually 30 miles an hour on most Brockton roads, and use your directional signals. Put your blinkers on when you go to turn. It would go a long way into keeping all of us behind you safe. Now, I wanted to let you know that I'm aware of 3 new businesses in Ward 4 right now. There is a restaurant on Main Street, 1753 Main Street, called Delicious. And my son and I have eaten there, and it really is delicious. It's very good Caribbean food. And then at 158 Montello Street, there is a restaurant called 79 Caribbean. Also Caribbean food, delicious. And finally, at 1289 South Main Street, we have Signature Kitchen. And I just tasted their food last night. It's traditional Haitian food, and it is delicious. So 3 wonderful choices to take out food or to go out for a bite to eat with your family. Give them a try. Let's patronize Ward 4 businesses. Now, school is going to get out here in Brockton at the end of the month, at the end of June. What are you going to do with your children? Well, the Brockton Public Schools have taken the time to create this wonderful summer resource guide. And I've been paging through it these last couple of days. Just a multitude of suggestions of things to do with your children. There's a page in here that talks about 10 Fridays, 10 venues, 100 things to do that are free. And it lists every Friday in the summer. All kinds of activities all over Massachusetts, actually, in Boston, in southeastern Massachusetts, and in Brockton. You should check it out. You really should. Thank you so much for watching Facts on 4. And if you've got ideas for my show, give me a call, 508-941-0108. I'm Susan Nicastro, Ward 4 City Councillor.